What is up, world? It is your man DH, and we are back live right here on Win or Lose Radio. Of course, this is the 9 o'clock hour, and I have a special guest that I'm going to be going to in just a few moments here. But I got to tell you guys, what I'm about to show you right now is the world premiere trailer of The Family Exchange, starring Zay Fredricks. Man, you guys, check this out, man. Check this out. So let's roll that clip right now. Let's play the trailer for The Family Exchange. Guys, so right there, you just saw the clip of The Family Exchange, and I gotta welcome my guy into the building with me right now. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Kev on stage. Kev, what up?
What up, DH? Underscore Ranger.
Hey man, Kev, I'm glad you could be in the building with me right now. Like I told you guys, he's one third of the comedy trio, the Playmakers, who just had a show over the weekend that I missed because I had to work. But one third of the trio, the Playmakers, actor, director, entertainer. Kev, how you feeling tonight, bro?
You know, God has blessed me abundantly. We are so gracious and thankful for all the bountiful blessings that have been bestowed upon the family. We're gracious for our Heavenly Father, DH. Oh, yes, we thank Him.
Hey, man, I'm about to put you in A flat, brother. Don't play. Hey, Kev, so real quick, man, like, a lot of people don't know about your story, about how, you know, how you even got to where you are right now. And I know I've been following the story for a while. If you can, real quick, man, tell everybody how you got your start and how you really brought Zay into the mix, man.
I was a stand-up comedian. Well, I still am a stand-up comedian. I was doing stand-up comedy, and I was doing the Playmakers. We actually started making plays. That's the name the Playmakers came from.
Right.
And we got really close to selling a show that was going to be rounded by a real producer. They were like, "Come, man, your place is great. We want to take you on the road. All we need from you is $250,000. We're like, "Oh, cool. Yeah. All right. So, never mind. I don't have that." So, I started focusing more on stand up when I got fired from my job for stealing boxes.
And, Hi, Craig.
Yeah. And then Playmakers started making YouTube videos. And my son Isaiah used to watch me edit them. He was like, "Dad, I want to be a comedian like you." And I was like, "Do you want to do stand-up comedy or want to do YouTube videos?" And he said, "YouTube videos." So the first one we did with him was called Growing Up Black. And it got a million views on YouTube, went crazy viral. Then we did another one with Zay Zay and JoJo called Lazy Parents. Mm. That also went viral. It was on like Yahoo and Bing and, you know, WorldStar and Top 40 and all that stuff. So that kind of kicked off their career. They started making videos for Optimus TV, which led to Isaiah getting a role as Buckwheat in a remake of Little Rascals.
Yes.
That's on Netflix right now. And they got a TV show on Nickelodeon, which just started airing in Canada like 2 or 3 weeks ago. So that was a blessing. And then started doing my own thing with the Playmakers. We've all kind of done our own thing, and then we've done stuff together. And I wanted to, they had been going out on a lot of the auditions, and he hadn't been getting them. And I was like, "Man, I want to be, I want to make my own movie. I don't want nobody to tell me what I can and can't do."
Right.
And that was the idea from for doing The Family Exchange came from. And I crowdsourced it, and the people gave, and thanks to the people of God, we were able to put a film out that's safe and family friendly. And we bless God. Oh, yes, we do.
Amen, amen. Hey, look, man, I really think, I'm glad I'm able to have you on, because I really feel like if there's any story of somebody really truly following their dream and really, you know, just using what God gave them and going to the next level, man, I think of you, because like I said, I've been following the story for a while, and just to see what doors, you know, were opening for you, man, it's amazing. I know sometimes you got to sit back and just be like, "Wow, you know, this is really happening, man." Kev, you still there?
Yeah, I'm still here. Okay. I missed the last part of what you said.
Oh,
but
no.
God is good.
Yeah, man, absolutely. I was saying, man, I know you got to kind of sit back and just think, you know, how did this all happen and things like that, man. I know sometimes you got to pinch yourself, right?
I do, man. I just know that it's everything happens by the grace of God.
Yeah.
And it's time for our life. If you're willing to, you know, step out there, and that doesn't mean the grace of God means you just wait around for things to happen. It means you go out there and make things happen and trust that God got your best interest at hand. A lot of times we feel like, oh, I'm just waiting on God to do something, but we got to move. We move by faith. Faith without works is dead. So we want the blessings of God, but we don't want to put the work in. We don't want to step out on faith. And it's the whole thing that unlocks the blessing.
Man, absolutely, man. I think that's that right there is just a message for everybody, man. If you got something, if you got a dream, you got a goal, man, you know, put God first and follow through, man, and it'll work out for you. Kev, how excited are you about this movie, man? Because I'm excited, bro. And I'll tell it right now. People don't know. I do have a very small role in this movie, you know, and I'm excited. I know you got to be excited 200 times, man.
You know, it's really, really, really surreal. I'm thankful to technology, man, because if I was out in the world, like, not in the world, like you said, I mean, just like living, like 20 years ago, it's just really impossible.
Right.
The technology was not, it wasn't available for you to make a movie if you didn't, you know, work at a movie studio.
Right.
There was no way to raise money from strangers. You know, you would have to have family members who had that kind of money, which I don't, but I had a lot of followers all over the world who were willing to give a lot and a little. I'm just thankful that I'm alive in a time where you can say, I'm going to make a movie and do it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Without a lot of money. You know, so I'm thankful and I'm just grateful that I have the opportunity to do it. I really do it for my kids, man. I want my kids to, you know, it's not about making money, you know, it's about showing them that when you want to do something, you can, and you can't let anybody tell you you can't do it, and you can't let the world and the way things have always been be a reason to prevent you from doing what you want to do, you know, because traditional logic says that you got to go to Hollywood, and you got to do this, and you got to get financed, and you got to release some theaters,
right.
You know, and then there's somebody like you who says, man, I just want to do this, and I'm going to make it, and nobody's going to tell me that I can't say Jesus, and nobody's going to tell me that. You know, because you can't pray, which has happened in prior stuff I've read, especially for the boys. It's just like, well, you can't actually say Jesus. Well, okay, well, I'm going to make it myself, and I'll say Jesus as much as I want.
Exactly.
Well, yeah.
Hey, man, you know, and like I told everybody, man, I'm thankful to you, man, because you actually gave me my first break, my first and only movie that I've been in. You gave giving me a break, and I'm appreciative, and I would like to say that I did a pretty good job, man.
You're amazing, and you know, you're blessed to be a blessing, man. The position I'm in is because somebody else believed in me and gave us a shot and allowed us to move to L.A. And I don't want to be a person who gets in a position where I can't help people and be like, oh, I'm not going to. I'm just going to, you know, keep it all for myself. There's plenty for me, and good givers are great getters. The more you give, the more you get. So I'm not going to be, you know, the one to hold anybody back. And if I can help them, I will.
Absolutely, man. That's awesome. That's awesome. Kev, man, what else you have going on right now? I know the Playmakers just had a show over the weekend. You guys got any more tours or anything you're doing personally coming up, man? What's going on?
Well, we got a couple of shows here and there, you know, once a month or so. And then the movie's a real big thing for me and doing stand-up. You know, I kind of always have done that. But, you know, we'll release this movie and see where the world takes us. Hopefully we'll be able to make, you know, more movies and just be an independent film studio and, you know, be able to take them bigger and bigger every time. And that's kind of my goal, to just be able to make family-friendly, content for people who want to have a good time, who want to go on Thanksgiving and you can put something on and everybody can watch it. You don't have to cover anybody's ears. That's kind of always been a goal of Change Generation Productions, which is the parent company name of the Playmakers. We just want you to be laughing out of the time, from your grandma to your grandma baby and everybody in the...
Man, that's awesome, man. I'm looking forward to it. I'm going to see you at the premiere in November. I will be there, and I'll take the cameras out so the Win and Lose Radio fam can check that out. It's going to be a good time. So I'll be there. Kev, where can everybody link up with you, man?
Kev on stage everywhere. YouTube, Periscope, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Snapchat, not LinkedIn, but everything else.
everywhere. Kev, you know, I appreciate you being on, and you know, you have a home here. Anytime you want to come on, promote, want to talk, anything, or if you want to come on and talk about, your Seattle Seahawks, which, you know, finally playing well, you can come on and talk about that too.
Oh, thank you, DH. I'd love to be on again. Thanks for having me.
No doubt. So, guys, that's everybody. Kev on stage, on Twitter, Instagram, everywhere, Periscope. He has really funny sessions on Periscope, which is at 7 o'clock, right, Kev? 7 o'clock West Coast time, 10 o'clock our time. All right, guys. Kev, man, I appreciate you being on, man. I'll get up with you, bro.
All right, take it easy, DH.
Later. Guys, it's my guy, Kev on stage. Man, good guy. I met him last year when we did the movie. Had a great time doing the movie. There are more things in the making for DH on the film side. You guys just sit tight and relax. That's coming. And I'm really excited for you guys to see the movie. The Family Exchange was a great time shooting it. Kev, JoJo, Zay Zay, you know, Jay Noe, my man Jason, and Davis, all good guys. Great time. So it's going to be fun to see the reception. I can't really tell you what I do in the movie, but it's pretty funny. You guys will get a kick out of it. But yeah, that was Kev on stage. So you guys know you can check this out along with more on our YouTube page at WTTS Radio. You'll be able to see this interview along with all our previous episodes and forthcoming episodes on the YouTube page at WTTS Radio. And we thank you for being in the building with us. And we are going to step out for a moment, take a quick break. When we come back on the flip side, we will discuss the Washington Nationals and talk about how crazy it's going on right now in the D.C. dugouts. And before we go, real quick, Green Bay up 14-0 with 13 minutes left in the second. Aaron Rodgers is balling. Thank you. Aaron Rodgers is balling. But look, we'll be right back right after this, right here on WTTS Radio and winandloseradio.com.